Welcome to my channel for Danny Lounge. My name is Mildred Lee and I'm trying to do, decorating a bullet journal. All right. So let me finish this last piece of high heels that I've put on a piece of pad and paper. But I see here that I am a bit short at the tip of the heel where the toes are. So, and apparently there also. I cannot move anymore to make it more, how do you say it, more compatible or more adjust. So I'm gonna put you on my mixer stand so I can run it to the die cutting machine so I can finish this last piece, because I have already done couple of hours in the afternoon to run this metal die to different kinds of colored and printed pattern paper, so I can clear the table also. That's why I want to finish this piece, so I can clear the table. I never throw away the piece of paper. You never know, you may need it. Yeah, I know, that's why I'm also a bit hoarder. So let's take this bit out. So I try with this palette knife to dig in carefully. So the top part, as you can see, can remain, but as you can see, some of them stayed on the acrylic plate, so I have no other choice than to put my toothpick through the places or spaces, so I can show more the print of the heel, well, the bottom of the heel. So this is just a job that you need to be very patient when you do that. And as I said, there is this piece where, as you can see, that I didn't pierce to with my toothpick. What I can do is, in case I don't want to fall out it accidentally out of this piece of paper, or a shape, or the die cut. So I use, let's see, washi tape to remain attached to the paper. So if I don't use any paper anymore, I just stick a little piece of paper. So I always keep the piece of paper, the end, a bit moist, and it will not dry out. So that's why I do it. And this piece I will cut in half lengthwise, like this. So the smaller part of pieces that is here, that's a bit too long. I'm gonna cut them. So I'm gonna use this last bit here and this bit here. So that, in that case, the, as you can see, this bit, this frilly bits, 1, 2, 3 bits, frilly bits won't accidentally get out of the die cut. I'm gonna cut right. need to do it carefully. I don't want to get cut more, because as you can see, the tip of the shoe, the heel, is gone, because I didn't have enough paper, and then this bit. So what I can do is just stick something on that space, so you don't feel that I have less paper and that you can see the deficit or the missing piece. So that's I will use this for later use, so I'm gonna put it aside. I'm gonna put this metal die in this empty space and then use with the palette knife, scrape out these bits and throw that in the garbage bin. So now, let's see, this. I'm gonna put the acrylic plate inside the die cutting machine, so I can put the whole machine underneath the table. And I'm gonna clear more the table because it's a bit messy. I know it's out of frame, I'm sorry, because I need both of my hands and you are sitting on a makeshift stand. So gonna be like this. So this is, I believe, one of the last projects, the Valentine's snail mail, and I got Niankao, and I don't like to use the Mandarin language because I'm more Cantonese, and we call it Linko. Yeah, this bottom part I didn't, this was the last part, I didn't watch it carefully and I burned it a little. Well, some of the chef cooks or amateurs will say, oh, it is caramelized. Well, it's actually burned. So this Linko that I, in one of the vlogs, in the videos I spoke about, I ate it not raw. My mom cooked the Linko. Well, she steamed it, and then you get this kind of mochi pudding that you have to cut in slices. So I've cut it, and then this time I pan fried it with a little bit of oil. Well, the Linko is actually already oily, but I'm afraid it will stick in onto the pan, even if you have a non-stick pan. So it's now cold, and when it's hot out of the pan, it's very warm and gooey and mochi. Now it's more cold, and like bubblegum, when you've chewed way too long, well, that's the way I like it. I took it out of the stand. There are some, I'm gonna show you. So these are the dots, small dots, light green. This is one of the die cuts. I forgot this little piece to cut it out, but the back is whole, and the reason for that is I've put two papers on the die cutting machine, and the first one, it cut completely through, but the second part, it, well, it did cut through, but not so as deep. So the frilly bits and the heel, the bottom side, it will not come out, in contrary with this one. So I'm lucky that I could have the whole die cut of the shoe. This one I couldn't save the frilly bits, so that's why I needed with the toothpick to punch all the parts out. So I will show you, let's see. Well, the pink one is the same as the other one, but I had this one, and the other side is the same print as this one. But the thing is, when you cut it through the machine, well, this is not the best, like this. When you cut it through the machine, this is like the positive side, and the back side is the negative side, so that's not the most attractive side. So that's why this side is more appropriate or more beautiful to show the one that you are gonna gift it to, or when you put it on your bullet journal or on your snail mail, you show this side more than the back side. So that's why when I run to the die cutting machine, this is also the beautiful side. And so I run this paper like this to the die cutting machine, and it will cut this beautifully. But then I turn this paper like this and use the metal die on top and run this side on the die cutting machine, so you get this side, the beautiful side. So that's what I did with the double-sided pattern paper. So wait, oh, I'm gonna put it back. Then I found the XOXO pattern paper, and I thought it was would be fun to have a shoe that's completely with letters. And I had another dotted pattern paper, but with color. And as you can see, this one I had to punch all the bits out, because when I lift it up, some already was stuck onto the acrylic plate, so I had to take all of them out. But these, I was lucky that the bits didn't come out, because I used washi tape. I used washi tape before I placed the metal die on the pattern paper. I put the washi tape first, then I turned the pattern paper like this, put the metal die onto the pattern paper, the pattern paper on the acrylic plate, and then run it to the die cutting machine. And that's why this die cut, the bits didn't fall out or stick onto the acrylic paper, and this one did, came out. Then I had this pattern paper. It's a bit gray with another print inside. I call this wallpaper print. Yeah, I'm sorry. I've seen too many wallpapers, so I call it old-fashioned wallpaper print. So I have also this. It's more like when you remove wallpaper, then you the wallpaper underneath is the more scrunchy, ugly wallpaper. I call this ugly wallpaper. Or the stone wall before the first wallpaper was stuck onto. So that's what I call this print. And I have craft paper. So this is craft paper with rose gold foil dots. And as you can see, the reason why the frilly bits was neatly onto the die cut is because I had washi tape already put in the bag. And here you have, oops, apparently it was a bit as you can see here, the bits were not taken out properly. Oops, sorry. So this is another pattern paper, and it looks like net stockings, but I thought it would be funny to put it on a shoe as a print, so that's what I did. I did have, I'm gonna put you back on the stand. So as I showed you, I had made two mistakes. This was the mistake that I have showed you earlier, the boo-boo that I made, because here was a bit paper that was less paper, and here also less paper, but I did another boo-boo. And I've put washi tape on the paper, and I forgot to watch which side I put this middle die onto. So apparently the beautiful colored dots is the ugly or the negative side, and this side was the beautiful side, but it was covered with washi tape, and I had to do, oh, that was the annoying bit of work, because now it feels sticky, and I had to remove carefully all the washi tape bits. And now you can see here, can you see? That is the bits from the washi tape that I cannot take it, remove it carefully. So that is, this is just a stain, and it won't come out. And you can see all through the die cut that you have different places with the green stains of the washi tape. And that is very sad to see that I've wasted a piece of paper, because I was making like a factory, making all the die cuts, and this time I was making at some point the one that I ruined. So that's what you also get, that you sometimes, if you don't carefully watch it, then you ruin die cuts. So that's the reality. So now I want to show you that I don't know if I have enough time. I hope I have enough time. So this is the bullet journal that I have, and it's not even half, and it's already like, it won't close anymore. That's why I don't use the elastic band to hold them together. So what was the last time I made? Oh yeah, the Christmas. So let's see, I've put this Hong Pao, the red envelope, in between, because I knew that I have a lot of glue stains. So I put them in here, so to catch the glue. But there is one bit, I should have put the red envelope not on this space, but on this space, because as you can see, the glue, there was excess of glue that glued the other side of the paper of the bullet journal. So now, and when I opened it, I heard something ripping, and I was looking at what is ripping now. So you can see here, 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 most of it's here, that is causing the ripping part. Here you can see also, you see, can you see it? You can feel it. That's a glue dot. So I'm gonna make, I hope I can, I don't know if, okay. Maybe I'm gonna be quiet. So don't be angry at me when I'm not speaking, because I'm doing something now. if I can find the washi tape that I'm looking for. I believe it fell under the table. Yes, it fell under the table. Nope. I'm gonna grab another one. I have several places where I put my washi tape because I have so much. I need one of these. I don't know what color I want to know. So I'm gonna grab some of the colors. And see which one is good. I'm looking for the washi tape. Can't choose between the pink or the blue one. Let's use the pink. Sorry about that. Oh yeah, I have to eat this quickly because I need some space. Yeah, I know, it's a bit burned. Sorry, I'm chewing because the reason why I'm doing this crafting is because of these shoes. I'm gonna put them like this because these are my favorite high heel shoes. Okay, they are not very, very high. But this is my favorite shoes because it's nude color. It's light pink, light dusty pink. And one of the famous Dutch women married with a famous Dutch soccer, paid soccer. And her best friend, I believe she was from Moroccan descendants, had a one-night stand with her husband. And that made to decide to divorce her famous husband. So afterwards, she was in collaboration with a shoe company. And she designed some shoes, so that's why I had to buy these shoes. And yeah, they look a bit worn out. They're not that beautiful anymore because the reason why is I had a boyfriend and he called me to so we can spend an afternoon together. And while he was working, he has his own store. And he's a very dandy man, you can say quite considerably of age, because I like older men. And every time I visit him, I wore these shoes. And one day I normally go to him with the electric tram, but this time I wanted to ride my bike and I wore these shoes. And after I visited him, because I don't go with him to his house after his work, I just went spent some couple of hours and then I went home. When I went home, suddenly it rained, so my shoes were wet, and since they were wet, they wouldn't fit them quite snug anymore. So, I don't wear these shoes anymore, but these still are my favorite. I won't throw them away. I still love these shoes, so that's why I want to put it onto my bullet journal. So I'm not sure if you can see it. I cut a little bit more like this, so I can rub the whole washi tape like this on. And I'm gonna grab some of the stickers. Oh, I forgot. The openings is on the front. And I love to have beautiful shoes, but the only beautiful shoes I have are three pairs, and this is one of them, the three pairs that I have, the high heels. And the heels that I have are not that quite high as is suggested in this, on these stickers. But you know, women love to have high heels. So I just want to put some examples in here. I want to do in the same size, so I can do like the second layer. Let's see. Let's see. I have to. Oh, I didn't do it correctly. You know what? I'm gonna do it on the dotted, because I know for sure that's gonna be correct and straight. Because I'm not the best in putting things on straight. So I have to rub my nails very hard so it won't loosen. Let's see. So as you can see, I have excess of washi tape on the outside, but I do it like this, so I can afterwards cut it correctly. So now I have to find shoes from other heights. This is not the 100% placement of the shoes, but I want to know where I can put the washi tape down. Like this. So I don't know if you can see what I'm trying to do. Let's see if I can find more higher heels. So now I have a dilemma. So can if I do washi tape here in between, I am shortage. So or I can just place it like this and then write something like some letters. So I think that's what I'm gonna do. I'm not gonna place another line. So as you can see, I have created a thing like the closet. You know, when rich people have an entire room where they have their clothes and their shoes on. So I have here a closet of shoes. That's what my intention is. Wait a minute. Yeah? Weet ik. Ik heb vergeten te koken. Oké. Ja. Geeft niet. Ik ben zo klaar. En dan ga ik koken, oké? So, what I'm trying to do is try to fit as many shoes I can do, but of course in a beautiful way. So it will be like my dream shoe closet. Because I've watched, what was it on Netflix? Being Organized by the two sisters that have their own company when they go to people houses and they organize their house or space, like one room or a couple of rooms. So I saw that and I saw Kathy Griffin. Where was that? Architectural Digest, I believe it was like that, on YouTube, and I saw her shoe closet, and I'm like, my jaw dropped. She has the most beautiful shoe closet ever. So that's what I'm trying to do, and that's gonna be my page for my dream shoe closet. Because I don't have a lot of money and I don't buy a lot of beautiful shoes, but I still love to see these beautiful high heels shoes stickers, and I wanted just to place them on my bullet journal and just dream about if I had money, I would spend it on a lot of shoes and have a complete room with shoes. So it's just a dream, you know. I don't live that big and I don't have a lot of money. I am not rich, but a girl can dream, can't she? She can, of course. So I'm gonna put you back and I'm gonna put you a little bit high like this and see if I can fit you in there. All I need to do is try to find shoes that are compatible onto the lines. So that's what I'm trying to do. And shade them, of course, in the color scheme. So let's see, I'm gonna do the black ones first. Is there a little bit? I think this one is, yeah, I'm gonna do that. So the lower black shoes I'm gonna put in here and space them a bit out and try to find shoes that have the same color. I'm not sure about that. So you know what? I'm gonna stick these immediately. Yeah, I've cut my fingernail, so now it's difficult to remove the backing of the sticker. All right. Oops. Of course, if you don't like it, you can take the white space out a little bit more, like this, so it can fit more onto. Oh, knife. I need to do it a little bit to the left. I think I'm gonna do it like this. So hard. I shouldn't have cut my nails. So difficult. Move more to the right, like this.